taken and tried. And he said, Abba, Father, all things are possible for you. Take this cup from me. Nevertheless, not what I will, but what you will. In Mark 14, the final events of Yeshua's life unfold. We read of the betrayal of Judas, of Yeshua's announcement about what was going to happen next, of his anguish in the face of death, of the abandonment of his friends, the farce of a trial to which he was subjected, and finally of Peter's denial and repentance. Judas' action, betrayal. Yeshua's actions, the new covenant, cup of suffering, the actions of friends and enemies, the friends flee, judgment and denial. Judas' action, betrayal. Then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12, went to the chief priests to betray Yeshua to them. Mark presents the betrayal of Yeshua's as a new sandwich story, a way to arrest Yeshua. The perfume is spilled. Judas betrays Yeshua. 2 days before Easter, the priests and scribes decide to act now to kill Yeshua. Before presenting Judas as the traitor, Mark presents the trigger that led him to carry out this action. His greed, the story of the spilled perfume, which occurred several days before, according to John 12:1-3. In Mark, the contrast between Mary and Judas is striking. Mary, he does not mention her by name. Gift to Yeshua, declare the value of the gift. His act was to be remembered for good. Judas, he mentions him by name, betrays Yeshua. The amount received is not declared. We all remember his act for the worse. Satan had deceived Judas and led him to think that he was one of Christ's true disciples, but his heart had ever been carnal. He had seen the mighty works of Yeshua. He had been with him through his ministry, and had yielded to the overpowering evidence that he was the Messiah. But Judas was close and covetous. He loved money. He complained in anger of the costly ointment poured upon Yeshua. This act of generosity on the part of Mary was a most cutting rebuke of his covetous disposition. The way he was prepared for Satan's temptation to find a ready reception in the heart of Judas. Yeshua's action. The new covenant. This is my blood of the covenant. This is poured out for many, he said to them. That year, Passover began at sundown on Thursday and ended at sundown on Friday, when the Jews ate the Passover lamb sacrificed during the day. Late on Thursday night, Yeshua met with the 12 in the upper room. At that time, he instituted a new covenant, the body and blood of the Lamb of God, represented in the bread and wine. A new covenant like the old was to be ratified with blood. After singing the hymn and leaving the room, Yeshua made 3 amazing prophecies. He announces the flight of his disciples. He announced his resurrection. He announced the triple denial of Peter. The cup of suffering. Abba, Father, he said, everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will. Arriving at Gethsemane, Yeshua left 8 apostles at the entrance while he entered the garden with the other 3 apostles. He earnestly asked these 3 to watch with him, to encourage him in these distressing moments. If they had obeyed this command, they would have been prepared to remain faithful and not give in to temptation, as Peter did. For his part, Yeshua asked his Father in his anguish to get rid of the suffering that lay before him. God's answer was no. For the love of his Son, he could have freed him. But out of love for us, he allowed Yeshua to suffer and die, to give us salvation. The actions of friends and enemies. Friends flee. Then everyone deserted him and fled. hiding his betrayal behind a kiss, Judas betrayed Yeshua. From that moment, events unfold quickly. The mob arrests Yeshua. Peter defends Yeshua and hurts a servant. Yeshua criticizes the way in which he is arrested. The apostles abandoned Yeshua. A young man, probably Mark himself, is almost arrested. Trial and denial. But Yeshua remained silent and gave no answer. Again, the high priest asked him, "Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?" We now find Mark's last sandwich story. Peter approaches Yeshua. Yeshua is judged. Peter denies Yeshua. Not even with false witnesses were the priests and scribes able to find a clear accusation against Yeshua. Faced with Jesus' silence, Caiaphas pressured him to declare whether or not he was the Messiah, the one who asked us to confess him before men could not fail to testify at that moment, "I am." This wrath of everyone present fell on Yeshua, as they mockingly asked him to prophesy. Yeshua saw how his prophecy was being fulfilled at that moment, but without knowing it, Peter was a demonstration that Yeshua was indeed the Messiah. For his part, Peter was living in his own trial, but unlike his master, he denied his sonship. Yeshua did not consider heaven a place to be desired while we were lost. He left the heavenly courts for a life of reproach and insult and a death of shame. He who was rich in heaven's priceless treasure became poor, that through his poverty we might be rich. We are to follow in the path he trod. He who becomes a child of God should henceforth look upon himself as a link in the chain let down to save the world, one with Christ in his plan of mercy, going forth with him to seek and save the lost.